हेलो, दिस इज स्वप्निल ममानी, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर, आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस महिला महाविद्यालय तासगांव। आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। टुडे वी सी द लास्ट फिफ्थ टाइप ऑफ द यूजर डिफाइंड फंक्शन, दैट इज द रिकर्सिव फंक्शन। नाउ लेट अस सी द एग्जांपल लाइक फैक्टोरियल। Start hash include ourstream.h and hash include conio.h. Recursive function means function call itself. Now see on the screen, we are taking one example like factorial. For this example, we need one function to be recursive. Recursive function always return a value. This is the return value with argument type function. Integer factorial, in bracket we passes the argument integer a. Condition is there, if given a value is greater than 1, return a into factorial of a minus 1. Means in this function factorial, return statement calls factorial again. That means function calls itself. That is the recursive function. What is the else condition? In else condition, return 1. If the given value a is greater than 1, always return a 1 value. Otherwise, a into factorial of a minus 1. Now, in main function, as per the previous programs, type clear screen and get ch. Take the variable integer t equal to 5. Suppose that variable is a 5. Output is compulsory 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. To get the corresponding output, result equal to, call the factorial function and pass the t value to that factorial function. That means the 5. It gives the result of 5 factorial. That means it will become 120. See out the factorial of t means 5 equal to result res. Now check the program. Success. Now check the output. Okay, factorial of 5 equal to 120. This is the recursive type of the function. Now in deep, we are going to learn about the call by value functions and call by reference functions. What is the difference between the call by value and call by reference? We are going to see. And when this need occurs, when we have to call by value, and when we have to call by reference. Let's take one example like swap. We are going to swap two given values. What will be happen when we call this function by value, and what will happen when we call by reference? Let's see. Take an example, void swap, integer p and integer q are the formal parameters. For the swapping conditions, take another variable integer temporary. Now temporary equal to p, p equal to q, and q equal to again temporary. This is the swapping coding. Now go to the main. Again take two variables, integer a equal to 100 comma b equal to 200. We want to interchange these values. We want output as a equal to 200 and b equal to 100. But see what will be the happen. See out, before swapping, before swap, a equal to a, sorry, a equal to a, read this, and b equal to b. Before swapping, this value should be a equal to 100 and b equal to 200. Copy this line and paste here again for after swapping. Paste here. See out. Change before word to after. Call the swap function. Pass the value a and b, 100 and 200. Change before to after. This is the call by value function, because we are passing a and b values to the swap function. Now check the output. Now take this to next line, because output is in the single line showing. So for the next line, slash n slash n, before line and after two lines after line. Okay, see here, before swapping a equal to 100 and b equal to 200, and after swapping also showing a equal to 100 and b equal to 200. Is this happened because of only call by value? Now see what is the call by reference. Just pass this a instead of by value, passing the address of that variables, that is the swap address a comma swap address b. Now take the pointer to the swap function, integer pointer p, integer pointer q, integer temporary equal to pointer p, pointer p equal to pointer q, and pointer q equal to temporary. This is the call by reference, because we passing the address here. Check the output. Output is as we want, because here you can see the changed values of a and b. This is the call by reference. What is a call by value and call by reference? A copy of value is passed to the function, but in the call by reference, an address of value is passed to the function. Changes made inside the function is not reflected on other function in call by value. Changes made inside the function is reflected outside the function in call by reference. And last, actual and formal arguments will be created in different memory locations in call by value, and actual and formal arguments will be created in same memory location in call by reference value. To get the more videos of this series, please like, share and subscribe. And please do not forget to press the bell icon to view latest videos. Thank you.